Hello, glad you could join us. Your timing is perfect because something special is brewing here. So a totally engrossing opening day here.
Ninth playing of this great event, and there you are, two relatively unknown names. Not a great looking scene. I've said many times, when you come and there's nobody here, it's the blandest looking place in the world, just acres of beautiful grass. When the spectators are all there and the pins are in the thing and that little corner, it's a magic couple of acres.
Live coverage of this third round is due to be offered by our host broadcasters in a few minutes from now, but not quite yet. Tantalising us, aren't they? But they're on the tee.
When you deposit tuppence in a bank account, soon you'll see that it blooms into credit of a generous amount, semi-annually, and you'll achieve that sense of stature as your influence expands to the high financial strata that established credit now commands.
Playing very nicely, and it looks as if he's got no more than about a 5-iron, unless he's the monster drive or been in trouble and just chipped out, which I doubt.
Viraj.
He likes it. Perfect balance as always, sails away, looks good. Is it good? Left, oh well. That's a very handy opening tee shot for the young maestro. Well, here's one of the men of the moment. What will the next 4 days have in store for him? Good one to start. Tee it high, driver. Good drive, middle of the fairway. They're murmuring. Oy vey.
So that'll be a penalty drop. Not even he can get out of there.
Oh, beauty. Back in the days I played here, it was a good drive and no more than an 8-iron.
The course is in very good condition, as it always is. Even though they knew the wind was going to blow, 90% of the flags are in almost impossible places, so they haven't become soft-hearted overnight. We've got some of the best, all the best players in the world here. So it will be a delight for the connoisseurs, something for everybody.
Flag at the back of the green today. It's so easy to go short and the ball spin back, and that's going to be okay. Good drive, middle of the fairway. And a beauty.
Second at the 13th. Well, it sounded good. Yep, nicely done.
Second, the par five. Oh, where's this one going? He's looking anxious down the left. Needs a bit of luck. Where's that gone? There's a little stream down there and some azaleas. It all looks very nice, but where's it gone? Not good wherever it's gone.
What for you, Peter, has been the most difficult aspect of the conditions? I mean, they must be the worst for at least a decade now.
I don't think we should get carried away with how strong the wind is. I mean, if you've been an old player for a few years, you've been out in a lot worse than this. But it's the condition of the greens, the speed of the greens, the position of the flags, the contours, the way they cut the grass, all sorts of things that normal folk don't take into account. As Paul just said, the 15th, you can think you're safe by 10 or 12 yards, and it stops, and it borders unfair, in my opinion. It's unfair.
A very frustrating golf course.
Got to get this right, because if he doesn't, not put a 6 or 7 on his card. Has he got it? Oh, was it buzzing? Oh, that's magical. Superb shot. Woo-hoo! To get it short and plug in the bunker, go over the back, very difficult to get down in two, and he may save his par. Well, that was an adventure to get the four under.
This longest putt for a par four. Struck it nicely. Oh, it stayed out. Three putts from long range. Just, well, it puts a little dent in his round. Yeah, that's pretty good from there. If it stops, and it does.
I've been coming for over 40 years, and I've seen it a lot worse than this.
There are hardly any easy putts on this layout. Sneaky green, but it made it look very simple. Very simple indeed. Now this is a little tickler. No, just didn't keep it high enough. You don't get all that many chances from 10 or 12 feet on this course. He's played quite beautifully today.
So a totally engrossing opening day here, when we bring you live coverage of round three till around about midnight on BBC Two. And on Sunday, the decisive final round. And you will see it all live from 6:30 until someone tries a green jacket for size. Bye-bye for now.